it will be a suicide for him for the Blood Oath, actually, yeah. This card. But then again, it's going to be the game number two. Philippines, Alice, it is a bit of a flavor for Team Philippines because it just tells us that they're almost the same in terms of sustainability, though. So for Philippines, it was a good pick, yet ambitious. So it is kind of crucial for them to actually execute this game. But then again, Indonesia with a carry pick, carry man. Carry was just the star of that game earlier, together with the Fatal Nix and the Seiko. A lot of pressure here for Team Philippines. Same goes with Indonesia. So let us see. Let us see, guys, on this game number two.
Different kind of funnel now for Team Indonesia, as they have this Selena, who it's a four for this carry to have two buffs. Now, Rabia Tussle in the middle, who's going to win this. In terms of EXP, it's pretty even between two teams, but the job does stun, of course, with the Abyssal Arrow. Definitely good for Team Indonesia as they take the first blood.
Actually, I'm not really sure if that was a good that was a good kill by Indonesia. But what's good about that one is Philippines with that kill, or actually death by Lusty, was kind of good for them to defend their orange buff. So Lusty was there with the orange buff, but again, here comes the damage coming from Team Philippines here on the bottom lane. Rich Jaya is down with the hands of Lusty, now at level 4 for his lane. This is a pretty good retaliation here by Team Philippines. Comes Lusty for the backup. He comes in for the stun. Immobilized, guys. He gets down as well. And the team fight is not get done because Lusty is down. We have the Cho here with a Chit Kuto. He catches Rebo or the Valir with a flicker in. He is going to be killed with a triple kill for this Selena.
Super easy triple kill there for the Selena. Team Indonesia backs it up. I thought that Philippines are feeling it already, but with that dive once again, problems now for Philippines as they're so aggressive. Fortunately for Cortese, he's a Ling, so he's able to eliminate that carry, which is good because he stops the progression. In fact, MMR is just a number, didn't get a kill. So that's the Bounty Hunter, only 3 assists out of those 4 kills, and he also died. Fortunately for him, he is near the buff timing. So at least Indonesia will get the buffs ready for the carry once again.
Actually, for Team Indonesia, what's good for Team Philippines rather is that the carry didn't get the kills. Rather, it was Milagres or the Selena. So will this app? I mean, Bounty Hunter isn't active yet, or is it working yet? But for Team Indonesia, but then again, for Team Philippines, you can see the aggression. Sika is down. We have a double kill here for the Thams, and Hen is just around the map of Team Philippines, just giving affirmations for Team Indonesia. But then again, Indonesia, they are aggressive right now. They're giving the space for MMR. It's just a number onto this game. They need to be mindful of this carry because the carry was actually the hero that defeated them at game over one. Philippines secured the turtle here for this game.
Very well done indeed, Chantel, as they have taken the turtle. That's very good for the Philippine side, and also getting a lot of farm on the LTZ. 104 on this Ling, 2.5k already with the Raptor Machete, and he actually opted for boots this time. You can see that some teams, they prefer not to have boots on the Ling, but instead with the extra armor and extra movement speed for this Cortese Ling, makes it sure that he's safe. But the arrow connects onto Lusty. Nice pushback coming up from Rebo with that Searing Torrent, but MMR's just number still wants to go for this, wants to go for Lusty, but he is out. That's gonna mean that Indonesia will have just wasted their time now. Flap TZ applying pressure against Rich Jaya. There's the knockup gonna come out, and not the best usage of the Tyrant's Rage. Bouncing Ball gonna be there as well. Rich Jaya says, no, maybe we cannot fight into this Esmeralda. Sorry, this.
Yeah.
Hen will lose the turret up top, but at least he's safe away from the Cortese.
Actually, that was a nice objective for Team Philippines, though. In the middle lane, there's going to be a team fight. The damage is there for the Selena. Here comes the Tempest of Blaze. Oh my god, the criticals. We have few on that Blood Oath, guys. They're going to kill MMR. It's just an over. Here comes the Fatal Nix by Lusty on Team Philippines. And Atlas is down, though. But then again, it's going to be a 2-for-1 trade in favor of Team Philippines. Nice synchronization of skills, actually. The sustain is just there. We can see Philippines try to destroy this mid lane turret, and they will take it.
Man, I like this a lot because Team Philippines are showing us a different approach and maybe a little bit of respect to the meta. Apart from the Lunox we're seeing in the side lanes, plus the Esmeralda, maybe we can see more mages in the side lanes as well, like Gushen off lane, or what Phil is doing with the side laning as Alice. With the ultimate, as well as the wave clear, he's able to sustain himself. Now they jump forward. They want to go for the carry this time. Nice! Wave of the dragon to control the crowd. He's delaying and he will be taken out. Hen with a very nice timing with the Jade Kondo and the wave of the dragon Lusty with that fatal legs. But the burst down though. Valir as well as the Alice burning them down. Will the Kufra go down with this? No, he won't. He's able to flicker to get away, I mean. But the better kill, the better value kill. Going for Indonesia can get the Evo as well, and then the turtle.
You know what, Wolf? It was actually a nice timing for the Jade Kondo and the Way of the Dragon for Hen. He literally went on for this Ling, and you can see right now, MMR is just a number securing that kill. We have fuel aggressiveness for this Alice, but then again, for Team Indonesia, the objectives is just there. Their mindset is just there. We just need to stop the sling. We just need to stop Cartesi and bringing about damage against their team. And we saw that earlier. I don't care about the other players as long as they get Cartesi. So for Team Philippines, they should be mindful in terms of their engagement or if ever they go for the initiation, because Team Indonesia knows how to end this clash. But again, we have Lusty here for the fatal legs. Actually catches two here because Valir with a senior turret kill spree for this Thams. And man, a series after another series, Arrow catches Rebo. He goes in for the purify though. The damage is there and it's gonna be a disengage for teams.
Was it the disengage though? They dove upon the Selina and they were able to punish him. Cartesi is there, and then they'll get the push onto the turret in the bottom lane. So that's really good for Philippines. They're getting a lot of lead. I mean, even after the recovery from Team Indonesia, it's still they're still way away. Well away from actually just getting back into the fight. Cartesi and the gang, they're be able to steal this purple buff away from Team Indonesia. Kind of just limits the farm from this carry, which is actually struggling at this point. He's just at 4.5k, but with a kill onto Fiu, this would be good. Hen tries to run away. Ling as well as Fiu combines for a good kill against that Zhou.
Although Belagas gonna take down few guys with that Selena, but here goes the backup. Philippines is bad after this one. He is out as well. It's gonna be a mega kill for these Thams of Team Philippines. Siku is there for the map mission though. Are they gonna burst him? No, they're gonna disengage, and it's gonna be 3 seconds here for Team Philippines. So start with this turtle objective against Indonesia. We have the breastplate, full plate again, actually for Rich Chaya for his item. Nice item though to counter out this Ling.
Yep. Bottom lane, Rich Chaya is gonna be caught, but he's able to just flicker away into safety. He's gonna be chased down by Lusty though. Rich Chaya actually sustain himself. Yes, he can. Lusty doesn't have any horse with him unless Cartesi decides to join in the fight. Maybe Lusty is just taking his time so that there could be respots. I mean, for Team Philippines, Siko jumps in a very precarious spot. They have to be careful here in the mid lane. But onto the bottom lane, the split pushing Flatteezy, able to score a turret.
And that was actually a nice buy time here by Lusty at the middle lane. Unknowingly for Team Indonesia, it was actually Thams taking down a turret against them. So far, for Philippines, we have the Berserkers here coming up next for the items here of the Ling. We have 5.7k gold though for this carry and the Necklace of Durance as well for Milagres on his Selena. So it's all about the initiation though. We have Siko for the Kufra. We have the Atlas for Lusty. So it's going to be the battle of initiations. If whoever wins the initiation, it's going to be the one winning the team fight. So far for Philippines, they're just all over the place. They're just minimizing the map vision and control of Team Indonesia.
That means that Indonesia will have much better... Not much better when it comes to farming. Because this is a problem. You only have the endless battle for the carry, and at this point in the game, with the Ling intact for Philippines, they're gonna get dove upon, your team fights will be forced if you are staying in the jungle or if you're staying in the lane. And the big plus for Team Philippines that they have valid split pushers. They have the TAMs, they have few on this Alice who can just clear out the wave and make it hard for Team Indonesia to make a play. But speaking of making a play, Lasty wants to go for the Fatal Links. It's gonna be pummeled upon, still pops the Fatal Links. But look at the Siri Dog combo! Damage from Philippines! Takes down two! Seiko's first hit, Shaya taken out! Call DZ dives! Tempest of Blade's gonna be used, nice timing as well, Canadian's out! Can they get more? Carry in trouble. Kaltizi dives and they'll get the triple for Kaltizi's Ling. And they're not talking to few. Making sure that Team Indonesia can breathe.
Yeah, the objective is just there. Well, that is happening. We have few clear the minion wave. Actually cutting the minion wave for Team Philippines. Kaltizi with the sling. We have Rebo for the support. And even the Atlas and this Thams for the support damage. And few actually taking down this inhibitor turret against Team Indonesia. Whoa, wow. For Team Philippines, they're just on a run. Objective after another objective. Actually taking the Lord against Indonesia right now. We have the Berserkers here now. We've seen the damage earlier for Kaltizi. This time around, it's going to be a lot more of damage coming in from him.
16 to 9, Chantel. And this is just like the repeat of game one. Or will it be, though? Because the main difference now for Team Philippines is that they have taken two inhibitor turrets. It's not like before. So Way of the Dragon can be committed, but Fiu is there! He knows where you're going! And with that stun, he's able to facilitate for a kill. Now FlapTeezy pops the Counter Inferno, Lusty fishing for the carry. There's the Fatal Links, he gets two. Rebo as well as Cartesi on the backlines! Carries down, Rich Giant trouble. Cartesi with the Tempest of Blade. Ling, the damage, the crits, all of there in there for Philippines as they have taken four and they use the Regal as well. Wipe out the bravado of Red Esports from the Philippines. It's still there. My oh my. They'll finish
this game. We have the Lord here. They'll finish this. We only have the show for the defense, although FlapTeezy is out, guys. The minions are just there. And this game number two.